on that site right now. Go check it out, roomonfire.tv. So
yeah, do that.
You know, shameless shout outs aside, it's definitely going to be really sick to see Globin, because I remember the last couple of times where DreamHack, they ran tournaments in Globin, and it's just like, you know, it's like StarCraft 2 and stuff, and you're just thinking, come on. So this time, CS is going to be the main event. CS is going to be on the main stage. Both semifinal matches and the grand finals played out tomorrow in the Globe Arena, which is one of the biggest arenas in Sweden.
Yeah.
So that's really cool that here in Sweden, we're going to have a CS on the main stage as a big draw. So if you guys are here, as Anders said, if you happen to be in Sweden or Stockholm, if you think you're in Stockholm, Sweden as well,
yeah,
you know, just, I don't know, astral project your way there. But, you know, tickets are still available, so you guys can go.
You remember yesterday when we had that whole issue about the metro closing? Yesterday went really late.
Oh man, that was a nightmare.
Oh, actually, never mind. We'll just go into it. That story's going to have to wait until later. It's 3DMax starting here on the terrorist side. It's Cash and 3DMax, the Finnish team, who did lose earlier on playing against Fnatic. A really hard match for them. And the same map here. We'll see if they can do it once, or if they could do a little bit better here against the Copenhagen Wolves, whom I'm not really sure either are very schooled on Cash, but that's where we ended up.
But they are going to have the iron defense because they're Danish.
Yeah. They have Nico, who is truly a little bit of an enigmatic AWPer here on in the Counter-Strike scene. Has some really incredible talents. Seems to have maybe not the best work ethic, and sometimes seems to not want to practice as much as everyone else, and sometimes just kind of gives up on the game for a couple of weeks and then comes back, but very strong player anyway. In the corner here, it's Pimp picking up the one headshot, looking for more, but he's not going to get it. Excited Disturb coming into it, and Nico will pick up one headshot on Natu, and that's another point to bring out, is Nico is actually fairly toxic, well, poisonous when it comes to the pistol as well.
Yeah, he's very good at it. Glaive is going to be the point man here, just trying to draw attention to himself. Smoke to actually force the position here. 3DMax actually going to get caught behind that smoke. This could be a good opportunity for Copenhagen Wolves to start moving in. Glaive with that headshot is certainly going to open the floodgates, and they're going to come rushing in, but Corona's holding behind the boxes and behind that smoke, and this is working out perfectly for 3DMax. They've turned this into a 1v2, and Kerrigan is no closer to getting onto this site.
Yeah, now walking right in front of the Finnish player there, turns around, but there's no time left for it, and great play from 3DMax. Xart picking up a double, Corona with the double. They played that great.
Yeah, Glaive's smoke actually coming back to bite them a little bit there, I think. Towards the end, that actually gave more cover to 3DMax than anything.
And it definitely did.
Disturbs his baby. Maybe like, oh, that smoke. All right. But that's already the start there for 3DMax. That is really what they needed to do to get the ground running. The other crazy thing is that Copenhagen Wolves have gone for a 3-scout buy.
What's up with these shenanigans here?
I mean, they saw Sean Gares do it, right? Why can't they?
Does it take 3 Danish people to make up 1 Sean Gares? Is that what we're saying here?
Well, I mean, devilishly handsome Sean Gares. It is tough. And I mean, he Scout, is. Have you seen him Scout?
Yeah, I often find myself just dreaming about Sean Gares.
That Mirage bench play, man, that's going to go down in the history books. Cloud9. So sick. Cloud9 need to get back over here into Europe and start competing in some of these tournaments as well.
Yeah, and luckily the Cloud9 organization seems to be willing to send the team places, so that's very cool. We should be very happy for that. That's the case.
Yeah, we're just waiting. We're just waiting to see North America, iBuyPower, and Cloud9. When are they going to roll in again? Cajun B. However, he's going to manage to get the drop on one. It's going to be returned quickly by Disturb, though, and now it looks like 3DMax are going to be moving out fairly quickly onto this B site. There's still oversight here from Nico, but Kerrigan doesn't need it. Kerrigan gets a triple kill with the 5-7.
What is he doing? He's going to walk in looking for another one. Natu now in a pretty awful one-on-two here, trapped in the corner, and Kerrigan will pick up 4 kills. What?
How is that even realistic? I mean, yeah, exactly. 3DMax right now, they're not going to be pleased with that. That's frustration right there.
I feel like that's the appropriate response. When that happens, you know, you just, like, take your hands off the keyboard and wonder.
Yeah, stretch the eyes. Don't facepalm too hard, Natu. I mean, that's really incredibly frustrating, because you think to yourself, we've got this in the bag, right? We've got the rifles, we got the guns, now we just need to get onto this site. There's a guy on the site, okay, we get through him, right? And then all of a sudden, Kerrigan is there to just ruin the party completely, shatter all your hopes and aspirations.
And if you do lose the Antico, you kind of rather you lose it because you walk into a bomb site where everyone is, not just because one guy decides to go nuts. Well, this time Kerrigan, he gets revenged on, and actually, look at 3DMax. They're not surrendering. They're fighting back here, and they're getting some great kills. And Nico's down too. The bomb is going to be planted, and it's a really fast plant. Copenhagen Wolves are going to have to move quick. They don't have a kit picked up currently. Oh, man, the Finns. They're not settling for a exit already. That was a very cool round from 3D Max.
Very clean work there, no doubt about it. Okay, B, then a great headshot, but he gets caught by Disturbed in the end. And yeah, Copenhagen Wolves are the ones shaking their heads now. They're not going to be too pleased with this.
Closest to the camera, we've got Nico, and then followed up by Pimp, and then Glaive down the middle. There is the leader, and a really, really good one. Mm-hmm. I'd say it's kind of tied between him and Fetish as the two best leaders in Denmark.
Oh, no doubt. No doubt. And, going down that line, Cajun B used to be on Dignitas, and AC took his spot on Dignitas.
Yeah, there was some Danish drama back then.
Mm-hmm. Well, Cajun was just like, I'm not interested anymore. I'm going to go and take a break. And then all of a sudden, 2 weeks later, he's on Copenhagen Wolves. So it was very interesting to get Danish drama.
Glaive hiding in the corner here, and it's right back to 3D Max rush in. And this time, Copenhagen Wolves actually did have a massive stack going on at A and some scouts to follow it up. Similar, what are we witnessing? What is actually going on in this game here
that we have anymore, Anders?
We're at 2-2. I mean, if we bring up the graph real quick, just for anyone who's just joining us here, it's this is not the pattern of a normal Counter-Strike game. Make it end.
One way or another, it will end. One way or another, this is a game of chicken, and there's only one winner in the game of chicken.
Nico got that. The follow-up grenade is a touchdown. Reflex is gone, and Nico looking for the fadeaway shot there with the AWP, but Disturbed is going to crisp him instead.
Disturbed one-ups him. He's like, okay, you got the HE. I got the barbecue.
Yeah, the Danish barbecue, right? There's some bacon involved. Though Nico is kind of fit. I'm not sure he'd be the best guy for it, but still, it's a 4-on-4. And right now, 3D Max, it kind of looks like they're trapped, but actually they're not. They have a really good way of wedging themselves into either bombsite they feel like. And right now they're going for the A bombsite, which is a good idea.
Glaive with the AD-AD spam that nearly drops Natu. Natu not going to be too pleased with that outcome. They're still working their way around here, though, 3D Max. They haven't committed, and they still got 45 seconds left on this clock. Corona's going to try and work his way in through connector, but Cajun B was there to stop him from pushing in. And now this is slowly but surely turning into a situation where 3D Max, they're going to get sandwiched in, and they are getting picked up as well. They're picked off one at a time, and they can't afford to do that, really. They need all the bodies they can to just be able to throw onto a site. Pimp is still solid. Plenty of HP on him, and Cajun is holding from upper. Haley gets spotted out.
Oh, Natu. What an angle to find. And this dub with the follow-up kill. That's just some thorough work. Wow. Sard going to take down Glaive. Oh, God. This 3D Max team, I mean, they looked well prepared when they were playing against Fnatic, but they got outgunned a lot by Fnatic. Right now they're playing against Copenhagen Wolves, and they still look well prepared, but the shots that they're hitting, they're beautiful.
Yeah, this is, well, now that game of chicken, I think, is about to come screeching to an end here. And Copenhagen Wolves,
well, it's back again. Copenhagen Wolves won the last round. Now 3D Max are taking the round back, so the pattern is going to continue. Big question is if Copenhagen Wolves feel like this one rifle is enough for them to force it up once again.
Can we bring up the scoreboard real quick? Terrorists win. Please.
Yeah, let's check out the scoreboard if we can, just to see how it looks here in the sixth round. Well, they are going to force it up.
Yep, so the game of chicken, it will continue. A bit late with the scoreboard there.
So the goal here, look at this shot from expect more stuff like this from Nico.
Yeah, that's clean.
But the big thing here is that the first team to win two rounds in a row, so if 3D Max win this, then they will have met their two-round quota, and then they can really start winning. If Copenhagen Wolves do the opposite, I think it's their turn to really, really start stringing some rounds together. But as long as they trade, who the hell knows how this is going to end up. Already a little bit of damage done to Reflex, but nothing too serious.
All right, now, and 3D Max actually just putting up a pretty good fight here for mid-control, which is going to give them more options going onto these sites. As you can see, it opens up short, it opens up a main, it opens up vents and the link. So we'll see exactly where 3D Max decide to take this. They are kind of gathered up around A right now, but it's still so early in the round that they can kind of work their way anywhere. It looks like it's going to be an A split, short, A main, and just kind of walk in there and see if they can't wrap around on the defense. That peak, though, that peak was a lot of information.
Yeah, he saw a couple of people. He only had a scout, so I think actually if he had an orb, Nico, he'd probably just go for the re-peak again. Glaive with a good body shot coming in there, and there's going to be a lot of follow-ups here. They're up on the high ground too. Nico's got the first kill, but Disturbed will pick one up, and the Glaive will actually get a good kill in here, but it's still a 3-on-2 now. Pimp finds the shot. Nico's waiting out here. Pistol in hand. Tries to take down Xart. And he's alone. And it's a no-scope scout kill for Nico. And the trend continues. I can't believe it. They're just taking turns to exchange really disappointed faces here. And wondering how this is all going to end. I really... Yeah, we need to bring up the graph once we get back into the game again. Just to see how funny this is. There it is. This is rare. This is a very rare pattern for Counter-Strike.
Extremely rare, actually. And, well, it looks like 3D Max are going to be the first ones to crack. Ooh. They are the ones who have to eco here.
But that's not... Well, let's give them the benefit of the doubt. Let's see if they can't bring it. They've done it before with pistols against rifles, but this grenade... Oh, if he has the HE, yeah, it's going to be really well timed here. Does a lot of damage. Kerrigan with the bombardment and the follow-up shots from Glaive. And finally, Copenhagen Wolves get to win two rounds in a row. It could have been 3D Max just as well, but they do come out on top of this one. Luckily, 3D Max, because of the eco, they could buy once again here, but... A little bit of a chance, at least, for the Danish team to start stringing a couple of rounds together. 3D Max going to try and stop them.
Actually wondering, now that the chain had been broken, if 3D Max were going to go for a double eco and just basically go and guarantee enough money to be able to buy consecutively, but also guarantee enough money to be able to buy what they want. But it seems like Xart, he's got enough for an AWP. Okay, cool, buy.
Well, another thing to factor in here is that 3D Max on the terrorist side, so they can more easily afford to drop a couple of rounds, whereas the main pressure is on Copenhagen Wolves to pick up the majority of the rounds, so... I still think 3D Max are in a better position than Copenhagen Wolves overall, at least in the first seven rounds that we've seen here.
Agreed. Some good. They've got some good pressure going in right now. Copenhagen Wolves. You can see 3D Max still trying to just poke about, seeing if they can't find a pick somewhere. No real execute coming in from them. Seems like 3D Max are just kind of hoping that somebody's going to be peeking around here from Copenhagen Wolves. And Cajun does actually go ahead and take a look towards the entrance to B, but I'm not sure if he spotted anybody there because we see no reaction out of the rest of his team.
He did. He did see one person, and I think he actually maybe saw in both of them over here, but the big problem is Xan has the AWP. Oh, a little bit slow on the draw there. Could have maybe been an opening. Now they're definitely going to ball back and play safely, but there's only 35 seconds left, and if they have another... They actually do have a couple of flashbangs here. Pimp picks up a double kill, both headshots, and now, well, this push... Oh, it works anyway. How did they do that?
Oh, and he tried to go back and pick up that frag, but Glaive is going to get caught. And there you go, Caron. Double shot for him. And 3D Max, that was it. They're right back into it again. One round of eco to let Copenhagen Wolves get somewhat comfortable. And now Kerrigan is trying to sneak his way onto this site. If he can land a money nade, this would be good. He's done a lot of damage.
Oh, this smoke is going to be... No, this smoke's going to be great if he can put it up. I don't know why he hesitated then, but that's going to give him a lot of openings now. Running in, looks for the kill, jumps up on the side, gets the one here. He could go for the straight defuse. Caron's going to have to run up here, out with the rifle as well. No, the Molotov, he's put it down. Can he still defuse? He can't. Caron comes up with a triple kill. And that has to be some Finnish magic involved. Those two headshots from the guys coming out of the vents, that was pure magic from Caron. And I actually thought he was going to... maybe the Molotov would have been enough to deny the defuse here from Kerrigan anyway. I'm wondering if it bounces back. I don't think we can see it here. But it goes all the way in. Yeah, that is definitely going to bounce back. I think this would have denied the defuse anyway.
I don't think he would have had the time with how long that fight took. I don't think he would have had the time for the defuse, even with the kit. So that was just very well done there by 3D Max, keeping him off the bomb. They lose a couple of members, and they actually lose the AWP in that situation as well. So XR is not going to have the sniper rifle to work with here, but still, they bring it back to a 4-on-4 situation, and 3D Max continue to apply the pressure. Copenhagen Wolves are on the somewhat favored side here. We're expecting them to come out ahead with the rounds.
Yeah, but the reply from the Danish team is to pick up two AWPs and an auto-sniper. So they've actually sunk all the remaining money into this one round. So they've got to come up big here. And Kerrigan does take down one, and Glaive will follow up with it. So Natu, first return kill. And how did Kerrigan pick up that one? Almost a third one, and it will be followed up quickly by Pimp. So one on another up goes down. Reflex trying to do this one on three.
Scary there. He does manage to pick up the kill, makes it into a one-on-two, and both of the remaining members here for Copenhagen Wolves down to half HP. So maybe it is like a one-on-one, weirdly enough.
Yeah.
So 3D Max right now. Reflex. He's still got 30 seconds, but that isn't a whole lot of time, especially when he's trying to walk there, because he doesn't want to give away his position by making noise with steps. And the door is open, so he's going to be able to get out here without making any noise, which is very good. But 20 seconds, again, unless he can insta-give Pimp when he rounds this corner, it's going to be very tough for him to get this done.
Right, he's looking. He does take him down. And this is great. The door being open or closed made a huge difference then. Goes to pick up the bomb. 10 seconds left. 9 seconds. Pimp. Or sorry, Cajun is going to actually readjust himself. Going into the middle, hoping that Reflex is going to get careless and just walk to the back of sight and expose himself from that middle area. No kit picked up. Kony and Cajun, and Reflex is not showing anything right now.
Not the best situation here. Cajun B is going to work his way around closely. Not sure if he spotted. There it is. The shot, but Reflex gets the clutch and a triple kill for him. Shatters Copenhagen Wolves. And that sort of situation is not one that Copenhagen Wolves can afford to give up, especially now when they're on the CT side. That's 3D Max actually passing into the lead now.
Yeah, this was a huge clutch from 3D Reflex. You've got to remember, he got the first kill on the guy in the middle, so it was actually a 1-on-3 that he started off with. And then he won the subsequent follow-up then. Huge play from Reflex. And, I mean, Copenhagen Wolves had a big advantage going into that. Kerrigan with the Ultra Sniper in the beginning took down a bunch of kills in that A-bomb site, so they probably should have come out on top there.
They certainly should have. Pimp getting caught off guard like that as well. It seemed like he was looking towards shore, and wasn't able to readjust his aim in time. Disturbed, no problem with the aim there. Manages to headshot Cajun B from across the map. XR's going to catch them snooping, and... Well, Nico, we'll get a nice free AWP, and that's kind of like the worst player on Copenhagen Wolves to give the AWP to.
Yeah, but is he going to be allowed to keep it? I seriously doubt it. They should be hunting for him here, because you're absolutely right. I mean, the funny thing about Copenhagen Wolves, really, is that they essentially have 5 AWPers.
Mm-hmm.
Say maybe Pimp and Glaive less so, but Cajun, Kerrigan, and Nico are both well-known to pick up AWPs, so...
Oh, hell, for a time, Pimp wanted to main op.
Yeah.
I mean, and Glaive is very capable, you're right. I mean, it's actually crazy, the talent on Copenhagen Wolves. Their versatility is definitely strong, and Nico giving away his position here. He could get wrapped around on now. There's going to be enough time for him to get hunted down. If he doesn't land the shot, he's going to get back around the corner. Smooth play there by Nico, just barely getting out of harm's way. That keeps him in this match with that AWP, which is a great pickup there. For the Danes, that's a lot of money that they're going to save, $47.50 for that rifle right there. And compared to the rest of the rifles, that's a very large chunk of your money getting involved.
Am I the only one getting distracted by the fact that there are people playing 1.6 in the background when we have the stream on the 3D Max?
Noticed it as well. It's like two guys as well. They're just like having fun. Look
that
like Nuke.
That dedication. I think that was Inferno. Nico does get the side shot there, actually, the hip shot on, but Nasu survives and will take him down. Coming through the vents here, it's Pimp. He has to get a good headshot, but he's going to get taken down. And now 3D Max are just barreling into the bomb side. They're not stopping for anything. And the rest of the Copenhagen Wolves here, they are going to have to retreat, save their rifles. The Finns are looking to knock out the second Danish team here.
They certainly are. I mean, hell, this is basically tournament life on the line right now. They are definitely out for blood. And 3D Max, they've got a lot to prove as well. I mean, there's a lot of experience on this team, and not to alone, even.
If 3D Max can come out on top here, I'd rate that win very highly. That would be a very impressive win for 3D Max, especially on LAN. Okay. Copenhagen Wolves is a team that actually did remarkably well at Cologne, and very nearly took down Na'Vi and Dust2, which is in itself is actually not that easy. So, yeah, to beat Copenhagen Wolves here would be a strong statement, I think, for the newly minted 3D Max just picked up by the organization.
Yeah, but one thing to consider is that they have still been playing together for a very long time now as Encore.
Yeah.
So, you know, they get picked up now by 3D Max, but this team has been together, and latest LAN result, I think, is Asus ROG, where they came in second behind My Revenge, a Danish team led by Barry. So...
Yeah, but I would still say that the difference between My Revenge and Copenhagen Wolves quite significant. There's a big skill gap between the two there. Grenade to follow here. Danes, they are mainly ecoing except for the two rifles they saved. Is it going to be enough? They're going to go for the counter boost. The Danes have actually tried as well, but the Molotov here is going to keep them... It's going to keep their feet warm.
Yeah, it's going to be keeping them warm and toasty, and it is fall outside. Nasty rain and cold. They try and spray through as well, because they know that Pimp was legged, so they're trying to just catch him. He drops them down to 7 HP. Pimp is somehow here, though. He's persistent. And Glaive on the edge of getting boosted over, but little does he know there's three guys waiting for him. Still gets the parting headshot on Exart.
I guess it's something. But 3D Max are apparently hard to catch off guard. They're ready for a lot of stuff here. Cajun with a good headshot, though, onto Reflex is going to give them a bit of a chance to maybe bring it back.
Oh, this could get awkward for Exart as well. He doesn't have a whole lot of HP. Pimp is still waiting just below. Oh, but Caron checks it.
Yeah, hugs the wall and just straight turns the corner.
Going with the trick smokes. Throwing it directly, that's not good enough. You want to hit a wall first. It's a snooker with nades. Still looking to see exactly where 3 Max are going to take this, though. 17 seconds left does not leave them a whole lot of time to act. Cajun D is still alive in CT as well with that Deagle. He could be looking for the shots. Going to try it, but Disturbed is going to shut him down. And with 9 seconds left, they're going to get onto this site and manage to find this plant. Finally, 3D Max. They continue to press forward.
The best we can say right now for Copenhagen Wolves is that they have both their rifles that they saved the last round still here. They got the one kill on Reflex, and Nico is looking for some exit franks. So... not a lot to celebrate right now if you're on the Danish side, really.
No, that's true. It's definitely a struggle. I mean, they especially when you're thinking Copenhagen, they're usually very good on the defense on CT side of any map. And this time around, 3D Max just continue to find those angles. It was so touch and go at the beginning of this as well. It could have gone either way. And it just seems like 3D Max, now that they've got the money to be able to continuously buy up, they're not giving up on this. Natsu, yeah, he's leading them very well right now. And be sure to tune into his stream as well, Natsu Nishu Twitch, or it's like follow him on Twitter, Natsu CSGO.
Yeah, but it's like it's best spelled backwards, right?
Yeah.
It's very confusing.
Natsu Nishu, something like that.
I've given up on it, but yes, follow him on Twitter. That's an easy way to see when he's streaming. He does a lot, he plays with viewers as well, so you guys should definitely do that. Yeah, and he's, as I said earlier, a really, really great guy. But also Sniper and AWP back on Copenhagen Wolves. They need to make this 8-7. That would be reasonable. Wouldn't be great, but it would be within the sort of margin of error for Copenhagen Wolves at least. And Kerrigan is over here, auto sniper in hand. Natsu thinking about doing it. Don't do it, Natsu. He does it, and it doesn't work out.
No, it doesn't. Not this time.
And look at how much damage have. They must have been hit by some fairly devastating grenades in the middle to be that low, all of them.
And Glaive will manage to pick up another one, so Exart gets dropped, and Nico picking him off as well as they round the corner. This is going to be Reflex and Disturbed now in a 2-on-5. They're split up as well. One of them over by Squeak, one of them in mid with that bomb. Not the best position for Disturbed to be approaching this site on. He's going to get wrapped around, caught in a crossfire. Goes for Nico, gets that kill, but Glaive is going to jump on him.
Reflex is going to go down. The auto sniper prevails a little bit here. Now you've got to wonder, how is the money looking right now for the Danish team, and for the Finnish team too. Because that's going to make a big difference for the remainder of this. They can buy 3D Max in this round, but they could also buy the next one. So yeah, they've actually done a really good job.
Yeah, they've got a good bank going in. Seems like for a second they wanted to just go for a full yellow rush. But they're going in, they're actually going to set up a smoke round here, Natsu. Look at this. Smoke positions, this is definitely something that 3D Max have taken the time to prepare. They're going to have two smokes going in, the flashes as well. Exart leading the way in A main with that AWP, but he hasn't found anybody peeking here for Copenhagen Wolves.
It's going to be for mid and truck right here. And wondering if they're going to commit or they're going to rotate back. No, they actually, yeah, they throw the smokes, then go back through main, because that's where the smokes are covering them from. Kerrigan, auto sniper, not going to work out. Exart is gone to Glaive. He's going to have to come up big here. Does put a little bit of damage in. It's nowhere near enough. And Natsu comes around and takes revenge on him. And 3D Max slows around, and they're back in the driver's seat. Pimp in a 1-on-4 looking for a headshot. He's going to pick up a good one there, but it doesn't matter anymore. It's too late for him to win this round.
The bomb has been planted, unless he can manage to land some sick shots. I mean, he's got an HE, he's got a Molly, he doesn't have a smoke. But he doesn't have a whole lot of time to act, and it looks like he's just going to get in position to try and catch some exit frags as 3D Max trying to run away to save those guns from the explosion. Copenhagen Wolves, I mean, again, losing a lot of momentum here. It just seems like 3D Max are able to shut them down. Now, after that very touch-and-go beginning to the half, it's going to be 9-5 for 3D Max on the T side of cash. That's an excellent scoreline. Pimp may be able to catch Natsu off guard here, but Natsu just barely, or it's Exart rather, he just barely makes it around the corner.
Oh, man.
And they do not look pleased right now on the Danish side.
Pimp not able to find him. I guess there's a nice attempt to get a little bit of something at the end. But even if he had, it's not like that would have forced anyone to eco. It would have just been like a moral victory kind of thing. You know, I got you at the end, and that feels good.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, exactly right. I mean, it's not going to have a huge impact on the money, but it's going to be... we're still going to have Copenhagen Wolves actually having enough money for a double AWP play here. So there's actually a pretty good buy coming out on the Danish side. 3D Max, they get to buy whatever they want. Well, I don't think a 6 foot hole was what KGB was looking for. KGB is looking for more kills. He manages to pick up another one.
Yeah, pretty nicely done here. So, and a completely different kind of defense from what we've been seeing the other rounds here. Should be nearly impossible for Corona Nato to get much done here, though Pimp is offering himself up a little bit. He's going to pick up the one kill and very nearly gets Corona as well. So it's not all bad here. 1-on-4 with only 5 health. Best move right now, go in a corner and throw that Molotov and burn yourself. Just yes. Make sure they don't get you.
Well, come on.
That's how I play Counter-Strike anyway.
We need it.
So 9-6 for the first half is not very satisfactory for Copenhagen Wolves. You can see they're not excited either. You know, it doesn't rule them out. It doesn't mean they can't win. But right now 3D Max they're quite far in front, I would say.
No, Copenhagen Wolves can still do what 3D Max did in the first half. They can still manage to come out ahead in T rounds. Cache is a bit like that, where it's a bit of a CT sided map, but it's a little bit like Dust 2 right now, where it's like it can kind of go either way. CT side on Dust 2, you can still pick up a lot of rounds. So Copenhagen Wolves right now, if they were to pick up this pistol round, they may be able to just tie it up and put some pressure on 3D Max. We're gonna need to see some creative play out of them to do it though, because right now 3D Max, they've got all the confidence. If they pick up this pistol round, they very well could just end the game right here.
Very true indeed. Glaive has already taken a little bit of damage. 3D Max, long range here is pretty good for the, you know, P2000 or the USPS. So I think Copenhagen Wolves, they should get closer with their Glocks. I prefer on Cache to see like explosive terrorist pistol rounds where you get up close to a corner and then as soon as you, you know, pop a flash or you open up with a kill, as soon as you spot anyone or anyone spots you, you all just went around the corner. Because then you're close enough to make it work. And actually, 3D Max have a nice setup over here.
Pretty prime position. Disturbed. He's going to be checking this angle. Nicely done. That sets it up for Reflex to take the peek. And Reflex is still here. They just annihilate the push coming in from Copenhagen Wolves. It's going to be Glaive tempting his luck.
Beautiful.
But that was, yeah, that's about as clean as it gets right there in a pistol. They ran right into the blender. 3D Max are looking very good now. 10 rounds on the board for them. They get the guns.
And I think that was Device in the background from Deaton Tuss shaking his head and walking away in disappointment. All right, then. Yeah, but 3D Max just playing this really nicely. There's a nice balance right now on this Finnish team between good individual aim and then very good team play. Mm-hmm. Just playing and trusting each other to hit these shots and you know coming out on top like that. I like it.
Yeah, that was a very nicely executed crossfire setup there. Corona's going to be boosted up on here as well on Sky. There's going to be a nice shot from Kerrigan, and it continues, Anders. This is it. It's going to be, well, a good kill there by Corona, keeping his cool. Brings it back to a 4-on-4, but I'm totally expecting Copenhagen Wolves now to win this round.
Are we going to go back to the first half madness? Corona says no, and does pick up a double and almost a triple as he almost takes down a Kerrigan in the background here. Glaive can't survive, so it feels like, oh, wait, what? Is he said? Finally, they're going to get him now, Nico. In the back of sight, is going to get taken down. So yeah, there is an end to the madness, although it was looking a little bit shaky at the beginning.
That was a pretty cool shot, I have to say. One click, you're done. CZ or not, P250 or not, it's all good. Gets the damage done. But right now, it's all about 3D Max keeping their cool and not letting Copenhagen Wolves back into this game because they've got a good lead at this point. Copenhagen Wolves should be actually going for a force buy here. They've got the rifles, limited nades, only 3 smokes, 2 flashes, so it's not going to be very flashy work that we're going to be looking here from Copenhagen Wolves. It's just going to be coming down to the fire, to the rifle fire. And 3D Max, look at this. The flash in, it's an A main and a free kill. Thank you very much. Goodbye, Nico. And 3D Max now have the man advantage.
Yeah. That is simple strat coming up. 3D Max taking a bit of a peek. Don't even really have to overcommit to it, but you know, if you do find a lot of people in there, you can sometimes get away pretty cleanly as well because they're going to be flashed. So, yeah. Simple stuff. Actually, Copenhagen Wolves have their manager with them here as well, which is Mini.
Yep, with
Mini. In case anyone recognizes that name.
Mini.
Well, flashbang in return. Kerrigan getting brushed away over there. Natu all the way in the back. Not touched by much yet. And it's going to try and buy a little bit of time here. Still 40 seconds left. It will be Koron. Then Kerrigan with a good return. And Natsu's going to go down as well. So it's a nice opening right here. But Koron seems to be unstoppable. That's a quad kill before Reflex does pick up the last one. And there you see a little bit of celebration going on the Finnish side. And actually, this is something that's, I don't know, I think this is a Finnish mentality thing. They don't get, like, super excited. I remember in when Alu was playing at Ufinity, he had some moments where he won on three, I think it was the then Epsilon team or something. He, like, won on three of them with the AWP, no-scopes and everything. And everyone else on that team were high-fiving each other, and Alu almost shrugged. It was almost like, eh, all right, you know, I just did that. They're kind of cool people in that sense. I mean, it's going to take a lot to get them that excited. But they're winning. They should be excited. And they're going to open up again here. Two good kills coming in for 3D Max.
Yeah, you would think that the only thing that gets a Finn excited is a sauna, basically. Yeah, they're gonna, that's when their eyes light up and you get the grin and they're like, oh, okay, sauna.
I don't know.
Sauna.
Maybe being out in the wilderness with a bow and arrow hunting a moose, you know.
It's more like skating around on an ice lake with a bottle of vodka. But okay.
I don't actually know much about Finland, obviously, but... The only time I've spent in Finland was in the airport.
I'm taking Natu as the example. Happiness is putting your TV out in the yard and watching some CS from the hot tub. That's happiness.
Well, can't disagree with that statement. Caron picking up another kill here, and actually they do share pretty reasonably. 13-6. 3D Max are close to being able to try and see if they can fight Dignitas and either make it through to Globen or not. That's the next game coming up, potentially, unless Copenhagen Wolves can come up with a really cool comeback here. If we can bring up the scoreboard real quick, just wondering. It is Caron top fragging. Yeah, no big surprise. Close by is Kerrigan at 18, but this is looking like it's going to be a big day, I think, for the Finnish team.
Yeah, can't get ahead of themselves. I mean, it is going to be fairly close up until 16 rounds. Copenhagen Wolves are absolutely capable of coming back into this. And look at this. They're prepared for this kind of play. The counter boost, reflex, he gets over. Spots the bomb, but he's going to get caught by Cajun B. That was a really clean play there by Copenhagen Wolves, preparing for anything, essentially. Cajun B could have sat there for 30 seconds just watching. And if nothing happens, fine. But he's ready for the one situation where 3D Max decide to go for that play.
And it's a play that Copenhagen Wolves themselves did. Mm-hmm. So I guess in that sense, there's also a reason why they might suspect it, you know.
That's a very nice play. It depends on the timing, of course, but it opens up a lot of options. Cajun B is completely blind right now, but the smokes have gone down to cut up mid, and this is going to open things up here. They could go for this B split push, and it looks like that's exactly what Copenhagen Wolves have in mind. They've got the bomb moving in from the main, and three guys dropping into checkered. This is all about Exart now. Three guys here for 3D Max, but they need to land the shots, and Kerrigan, he's already starting off strong.
Exart actually picking up that kill, but Nico's going to take the one on Exart, and Natu and Caron should be running away, but Natu's looking for some exits. And actually, he's got Caron backing you up. So I think that more than anything, they're looking at a bunch of exit kills here if they can, which is actually a very good idea.
If they could find a pick fast enough. I mean, they are here pretty close once that bomb went down. So it's not like they lost a whole lot of time. But Natu's going to find the headshot on Nico. That actually opens up this site. Oh, but the shot coming in, and that's going to be both kills, Kerrigan and Cajun B.
Now, the reason that made sense for 3D Max to go for is because they're going to have enough money to buy anyway in this upcoming round. And if they could have taken, I think one kill wasn't enough to make it worth it, unfortunately. But if they could have taken two or three or more, then they'd be in a position where all they need to do is win one more round and then they almost win the game. So it's like a calculated risk. And I think I actually agree with 3D Max doing that. I just wish they could have picked up one more kill. That would have made it worth it.
Oh, exactly. Well, that would have really put Copenhagen Wolves in a bit of a bind going into the rest of this. So, nade in. Not sure, was that a teammate for a second there? I was looking at the score, but
no,
all of a sudden, yeah. Nico.
They traded nades.
All right, so they traded nades. I was about to say, that was a bit awkward.
Yeah, Nico coming out a tiny bit on top. Not really much that really makes a difference, but...
No, it's certainly not game-ending here. 3D Max continue to have a focus on mid right now. Boosting a man up in vents to keep an eye on the boost spot right now. Two holding from short, so they have a very interesting hold here for 3D Max. I mean, they are just kind of leaving one guy over on the B site to hold things down by himself. That's Exart with that AWP.
Where are they going this time around? Feels like they're just feeling out the map still, Copenhagen Wolves, because the bomb's all the way in the middle, so could be anything at this point. They are gravitating towards the A side of the map, and that is where 3D Max have a pretty decent setup. One guy in the corner here, Natu, he gets taken out quick. Maybe there's an opening, but if he doesn't, he's going to stay alive, and backup's going to be coming in really fast, and that Molotov is making it even harder here. Natu, almost the double spray down, but Caron, who is the top fragger right now, coming up with the one. The bomb is planted in front of the site here, and he's still going to get the kill through on Kerrigan. Just such a great angle, and Reflex looking to ruin Copenhagen Wolves stay here. Cajun is going to be going down, and that's Caron with a triple kill. Even more kills in this round. It's completely absurd. 14-7, and can we check the scoreboard real quick? Again, Caron, 22 kills.
He's having
a great game, a fantastic game.
This is the important bit, though. They're going to have enough to force up here, Copenhagen Wolves. It's either they force up or they play for overtime. But they do have the option to force here. It wouldn't be throwing it out completely because they're going to have like three guys with adequate money.
If they win this game 3D match, we got to get like a winning shot at them because the finish cool is just continuing. Oh, God. For some reason, I find it very interesting how relaxed they are.
Yeah, it is going to be the force, though. Very interesting. I mean, Copenhagen Wolves at this point, they're going for the win. They're not interested in overtime. Two guys on pistols, but they still managed to pick up three AKs. Reasonable number of nades as well, so they can actually go for something here. And again, they go for pretty standard slow play. Not really pushing out too far around. It's Exart who goes hunting, in fact, and he's going to find Kerrigan over on B. So this is a good opportunity here for 3D Max to lock this down with this man advantage. They need to come back and pick up this gun. They don't want to let Kerrigan's gun just kind of float around. And there we go. Pimp does manage to get it.
Yeah, and now if they are going to be crouching in front of this AWP, that does not make a lot of sense. Flashing their way in makes slightly more sense, but it's still a big risk. If Ixard picks up the right timing, he's actually going to be unscoping when they go for it, so maybe a little bit lucky there for the Danish team. Now they push through, still going to be taking another one. Now it's a double for him, and if they make that jump here, he's not going to miss. He's poised for this one. And oh, he does! The flashbang actually works, and he's going to go down to Nico.
And Disturbed is going to get flanked by the man, Glaive. Now this is a 3-on-3 retake situation. Good nade there, doing a little bit of damage, but this is still 3D Max on high, looking for a shot. Manages to drop KJB dangerously low. This is a scary situation here. Copenhagen Wolves are having to play behind the boxes as best they can.
And only now does the bomb go down. So Natsu coming in, putting a few shots through, but he's actually going to be delaying a little bit, waiting for his teammates. He spotted that one person. I think he knows there's someone there. So I'm wondering why they're not wallbanging yet. There it is, Reflex. That's the idea. Great communication out. And Nico goes down. Now it's a 2-on-3. That bomb planted very late. So 3D Max have more time here. Natsu very nearly gets the kill, but not quite. And it's a 1-on-2 here. Caron will pick up the one. Now he just has to deal with Cage and the bomb. It's all the way in the back here. This is a good bomb plant for the terrorist side, but Caron cannot be stopped. He gets it, but there's no time left. And Copenhagen Wolves will do it anyway, and he bounces his head up there. Oh my god, what a great round from either team. I love the communication between the Finns then. Natsu calling it out and Reflex picking up the slag. That was beautiful.
Yeah, it took so long to get that diamond as well. Yeah, this play here from Nico.
Yeah.
Finally, they managed to go through and get that wall bank, because you can tell Natsu is clearly convinced, like, I can bang through this wooden box, and yet nothing is happening.
I think the first time he did it, it was just a guess, but when we just looked away, I'm pretty sure he spotted out Nico
peeking. Oh, he did spot him.
So that makes all the difference here. Now, 3D Max are going to be ecoing. This would still be a very hard comeback for the Danish team to make happen, but it's not impossible.
It's certainly not impossible. It's just a long road. It's going to have to be one round at a time. That's all that's going through their minds right now. And I do like what 3D Max are going for here, stacking up on B. They've got one guy, Exart, just trying to keep eyes on everything. You know, take a look at mid, doesn't see anybody at the boost. He's going to go back over to A, and it's just kind of floating, you know, trying to make it sound like there's a lot of people spread out across this map, when in reality, 3D Max, they're all hunkered down like tigers on B.
Yeah.
And you don't outrun a tiger.
Especially not four of them, right?
A Finnish tiger to boot.
It's a scary thought.
We should be calling them polar bears.
Do they have? I don't know what animals are in Finland apart from moose.
Well, reindeer aren't exactly frightening.
There must
be
bears up there somewhere.
There's gotta be.
And you can't outrun them either, by the way. They're scary fast.
Bears, yeah.
It's true. They do like 50 an hour and shit.
You can't even go up a tree either, man. It's a nightmare. Oh, look at this. They're walking into it.
Oh, no.
Oh, this is brilliant. 3D Max.
Is this how it ends? Well, apparently not, because they're getting some really good kills in here. Natsu standing his ground a little bit, but yeah, they decide to take the bull by the horns, and apparently that works. There must be bulls in Finland somewhere, but Sart, 1-on-4 here, trying to make it out. Saving his P250, not really. And he's going to go down to Glaive at the end. So it works out, triple kill for the Danish leader. And it makes it 9-14, and 3D Max can and should buy up here.
Yeah, they've got the force, but the potential. There's going to be there's going to be an AWP on Copenhagen Wolves, but I don't think it's necessary for 3D Max. And we can see them buying up with the value bar at the top. They're pretty much dead even, a couple thousand dollars off. But they do have an AWP on Exart, so they just barely had the money for that.
Interesting, yeah. They value it quite highly, and I don't blame them for it, but gotta be careful if you're opening against Nico. He felt that, look at that, and he wants back up again. Calling out, come on.
It's like a kid trying to climb a tree or something.
Please.
Come on, carry me.
If he peeks over here, that's exactly what we started. This could be great, but oh, he shoots one pixel to the side and Nico comes out on top. Not sure. I could have very easily been Nico dead, actually.
Yeah, no doubt about it. Nico actually stopping, yeah, a pixel short. That was a near dead on shot right there. And now 3D Max down to man. This is going to be a bit awkward for them. They don't have anybody out in mid, but they do have one waiting in vents. And Cajun B, he's prepared. He seems to know that Reflex is up there. He's just going to hold this angle, make sure that Reflex can't come in.
Timing is everything. You see Reflex, he's just counting the seconds in his head, exactly when he wants to peek, and maybe he's going to go into information from his teammates, but Cajun is somehow outgamed him then, and it's going to be Caron in this bomb site. They take him down. That has to be good news. I think, like, there should be a high five on Copenhagen Walls every time anybody kills Caron at this point, because he's basically the raid boss, it feels like.
Yeah, he's making the difference right now. So him actually getting taken out, no kills on his name either. Oh, just the one, but still.
Yeah.
They've done a little bit of damage this round, 3D Max. The only problem is that Disturbed holding onto a gun isn't gonna make the hugest difference. Well, picking up another kill, that's actually quite nice.
Yeah. Anything that goes, right? Just save the rifle, get as many kills as you can, and hey, kill the raid boss. Throw more dots.
Yeah, but the question is, do they stop dots? Stop dots. And I wonder who gets feared. Is it gonna be Copenhagen Wolves who get feared into the whelp cave?
Yeah, I think so. More than 3D Max right now.
Are they going to get hit by the Natu tail swipe?
Oh, that's so absurd. That's ridiculous. Please. Oh, it can't be
incredible.
True. That is
incredible.
But at the same time, it's one of the reasons why Counter-Strike makes for such an entertaining esports title, because moments like that do happen. Oh. If they get that opening kill, it's not impossible that 3D Max end up picking up the round, and then there'll be a match and map point here. But they're back to pistols mainly, except for the one save rifle. Good grenade's gonna rain down. That's a perfect touchdown. I think Caron probably, I don't know, he caught that with his teeth essentially. And Xart and Disturbed are gonna be left.
And Disturbed has rotated over to A site through the CT spawn, but he's gonna be the one who wants to hold about as passively as possible to give him the opportunity to back out and save the gear that he has. So he's holding way back in CT spawn right now. Doesn't want to show himself. It's going to be Xart who's taking point. But Copenhagen Wolves are, I mean, honestly, the patience right now. They're like stone. They're like statues. They're perfectly fine with just sitting in one position for a few hundred years. No problem at all. Maybe they get worn down a little bit.
Yeah.
But
they don't want to give anything to the 3D Max team here. Got to make absolutely sure they come out of this round with as many people alive as they can, just so that if 3D Max get that 15th round, they won't have to be ecoing at the very least. And obviously don't want to give them any more rifles than they need to. Disturb will pick up the one kill here. Grenade is actually going to be a little bit long. Oh, he falls back into Xart. That's unfortunate. I think it would have been maybe a second too long then. And now Disturbed in a 1-on-3 here. Bomb. 20 seconds left for it. And he's about to make it a 1-on-2. Now they've got to be really careful.
15 seconds. So he finally gets that plant, and he's on top of this site. He doesn't have a kit, though. That's something to keep in mind here. He would love to have one. This would give him big options, but he gets a headshot on Nico. If he could find the last man fast enough, he's got the time disturbed still, and he sees him dancing, looks for the shot, but he doesn't get it. So close, but it's going to be Kerrigan clutching it for the Danes. And once again, they stave off defeat.
The movement, the way to throw that flashbang in and then walk around the smoke like he did, he's definitely in the minds of the Copenhagen Wolves here. That was still a very, very, a beautiful round from Disturbed. And he's at 20 kills, so it's not like he's been having a bad game either. 14 to 11, though, and 3D Max, I don't think they're panicking yet when it comes to, you know, worrying about the comeback from Copenhagen Wolves. I think we need to get up to, like, 13, 14 rounds before that starts to be on their mind a lot. But they can probably feel, you know, a bit of an itch somewhere that they'd like to just get rid of here.
I'd say they're keeping Copenhagen Wolves' money so low. This is another thing in mind. It's going to be an awkward buy for Copenhagen Wolves if they were to lose.
Yeah.
So 3D Max, I mean, if they just know, we just need to win one round, guys. We win one round, and the next one is going to be a forced weird buy, and we should be able to pick that one up too, right? So yeah. They just need to get over that hump, and that's what they've been dealing with for several rounds now.
It is.
Copenhagen Wolves, though, I mean, you have to admire Copenhagen Wolves. They're just playing this. They're not rushing. They're not trying to take any risks. They're slow playing it, going for picks and just waiting to see what 3D Max are going to go for. Again, passive positions all over the place, making sure that 3D Max can't come swinging at them anywhere to catch them off guard.
Yeah, definitely a very slow game that we're witnessing right here. But it seems to have been working out so far. And in the vents there, oh, Pimp falls down onto the pipe instead. And it's going to be moving very close here. Could have been a double spray down, but now they know where he is. And he can't get back up. The smoke is blocking him. Finally, they come in here. But Disturb gets another kill. Like, Sard's going to take down Nico. They got to get this return frag on, and he can't be stopped. And there it is. Match and a point. 3D Max holding on to it. I think that mid push from Copenhagen Wolves could have maybe worked out. But because Pimp was actually zoned out from his team because of that one smoke in the middle, they ended up fighting everyone who was over on the entrance to A there. Mm-hmm. They ended up fighting them almost one at a time.
Oh man, and look at this, Copenhagen Wolves. They've got two guns. They've got an AK on Nico and the AWP on Cajun B.
And if we bring up the graph real quick, Copenhagen Wolves, they won four rounds in a row, and in spite of that, they lose a single round and they're back to this level of equipment. And that shows you how close 3D Max were all those four rounds. It's a big difference we were talking about earlier.
Yeah, inflicting the economic damage, and this is why it's so important. Money is, I mean, money is the end-all be-all in CS.
Cash rules everything around me? Is it the Wu-Tang?
It's the Wu-Tang.
Well, AK and AWP, I'm not sure why they've put them like, I mean, Cajun AWPing instead of Nico. I guess he has been missing a couple of shots, Nico, so yeah, maybe they feel more confident with it. Cajun, a very good AWPer still.
Oh, he is. He's very capable. Surprisingly, he doesn't drop it over to Nico, though, regardless. And Cajun B, well, there you go. He gets the entry frag, and then a really cool shot from Corone. Catches Glaive on short. Cajun B will find the frag, though, and this opens up the A site. Rotation coming in from 3D Max, but they're going to be late.
Is it Counter-Strike or is it parkour here for Corone?
Yeah,
that was absurd. That was some very, very cool movement. But, well, the bomb down and in a 4-on-3, it could be that 3D Max are still going to end up losing this round. Some good grenades raining in here all the way at the back of sight. It's going to force Copenhagen, Pimp really low on health here, but Cajun will pick up a double kill, and this is not going too well. It's going to be a third one coming in there, and Disturb goes down. Triple for Cajun B in this one round. Definitely very nicely done. 15 to 12, and the money on 3D Max is actually not looking that good. So they're going to have at least one more buy round here before it's all over, but this is just great.
That was really cool.
I love it.
And I mean, the slow-mo doesn't really show, obviously it doesn't show how fast that was, but that really was blink of an eye. Like, it was just up and out. That was really cool there from Pro.
Yeah.
And I do like how 3D Max right now are ecoing. Not hard eco, there's still a couple of guys who picked up a little bit of money. The guys with a little bit more money on that side, but still.
Look at this.
There we go.
Yeah, but Ixar was faking it out. This was to get now to that close, and unfortunately it doesn't work. But that was a bait. Ixar was baiting Cajun there to try and get him to shoot, and then for Nazi to run in there. So there was an idea behind that, what 3D Max just did. Yeah. It's a good attempt.
And then Corone, he shows that you don't need any of those, you know, bait shenanigans or anything like that. No. You just rush somebody down with the P250, that'll get the job done just fine. Disturbed, is he going to show us the same here? Cajun, he is in the danger zone. And then that perfect flash. Pimp keeps his cool and gets the last one. Okay, this is going to be the big round, Anders. 29th round coming up, and they have the money just barely 3D Max, and they're going to go for the buy.
Yeah.
If they lose this round, it's practically overtime for Copenhagen Wolves.
Yeah, almost certainly. The round loss bonus is not stacked up high enough that 3D Max can really make anything off this. So, yeah. We've already seen one overtime on cash. I mean, we're being treated to some great games here. Everybody gets a chance to show us what they're all about right now. And 3D Max playing it very safely. Again, anticipating the boost in the middle, the counter boost that is from the CT side. But nothing is coming through, but they're taking it slowly.
Yeah, straight 2-on-2 setup. They aren't taking any risks. They have one man just kind of floating around CT. So three guys over on A. Corona's there to cover. And two guys holding solid on the B site right now. I was curious to see if they're going to go for any kind of boosts or anything. We have seen those in the past, but it's not going to be the case. They're just holding solid on the site. Copenhagen Wolves right now, they're just making noise around this map, throwing those nades, taking some shots, just trying to sow confusion in the ranks of 3D Max, force a rotation out of them. And we can see that's kind of having an effect because Corone is slowly drifting back over to this B site.
There's definitely an uncharacteristic lack of defense in the middle of the map right here for the 3D Max team. They're really holding back far back. I'm not a big fan of this. I feel like unless they hit perfect, just be bombsite and retaking is going to be almost impossible here. But they do land the shots, reflex in the stove. Two kills in here, and it's a 3-on-5. Now, finally, Glaive returns, and Disturbed will pick up a double. Can he get another one in? The bomb is dropped right in front of him. Cajun is going to go down in 3D Max. They make it through, and there is a level of excitement right there. They knock Copenhagen Wolves out of DreamHack Stockholm here, and now they have to try and fight Dignitas to see who's going to be making it through to Globen tomorrow.
Yeah, they know when to celebrate, when it's 16 rounds on the board, when the job is done. And that's not too, that's experience, years of experience speaking right there. But the Finns, they've got to feel happy about that win. That is definitely very well done. And they are not going to be the second team out of this tournament. That spot is now reserved for Copenhagen Wolves.
Yeah, that was a good game from 3D Max. Very nearly overtime, came very close, but that was impressive.
Way too close for comfort. Yeah,
congratulations to them, and I don't know what to say. I mean, I feel like we've seen the last two games here have been packed with really cool Counter-Strike.
Yeah, incredible. I mean, it's really great to see it on cash as well. Like, we haven't really gotten to see too much cash.
No.
So now it's like, what, every map? Okay, I bet you, Anders, it's going to be cash for the last map to decide.
No.
Yes.
I don't think so.
It's going to happen. I'm calling it now. It's going to be cash.
All right.
This whole group will be played out on cash. They can't break the trend now.
It could be. We'll see, guys. Look, thanks for sticking with us so far. And if you have been tuning in all day, then you can't leave now. You gotta pick up this last game. It's going to be way too good. Dignitas and 3D Max winner gets to go on to Globen tomorrow, joined by Fnatic, LDLC, and Titan already through NIP, not through. And then, you know, we need one of these last two teams to make it there. Before we get into it, we are going to have a really quick break. Yes. Hopefully not too long, because it's getting a little bit late here in Sweden. But you guys have been awesome already, so don't go away now. Stay tuned, and we'll be back soon.